Hello everyone, we are in the concept of 3D viewing. So as part of 3D viewing, let's move to our next concept, that is about projections. So this projection concept is used to convert a 3D object to a 2D viewplane, or it is used to transform a 3D object coordinates to 2D viewplane coordinates also. The transformation pipeline we already discussed in my last video, 3D viewing pipeline, where the viewing coordinates are of 3 dimensional and we need to get a projection coordinates that is of 2D, and that can be done by using your projection transformation. Right? So the projections are of two types, generally classified into two types. Those two types are, we have the parallel projection, and the second one is perspective projection. Broadly classified into two types, parallel and perspective. Again, this parallel is categorized into two, and this perspective is also categorized into three types. We'll see about in detail about them later. First, we'll see about what is parallel projection, then we'll go to the perspective projection. But what is the difference between these two? We'll see now. In parallel projection, we'll be getting the projection where the coordinate system, whenever we want to project, those coordinate systems are projected through the lines, through the parallel lines. Like if you have an object like this, let us consider. Okay, if this is your view plane, now this coordinate system for an object, or the coordinate system of your, these are 3D coordinate system, where these will be projected to a view plane through the parallel lines only. So you will have a point here, you will have a point here, and this is your projected line. Getting all of you? Now, whereas coming to perspective projection, here also the coordinate systems are transformed to the view plane through the lines that converge at a point. If you consider a point here, and the same example I am considering, if this is your view plane, right? Now, we should have a projected conversion point. Okay? Now, this is your projection center. Okay, now these viewer line will be like this. So this is how that will be done in a perspective projection. Now what is the difference between these two is, it will preserve the distance, or it will preserve the relative distance between the points, but the realistic display may not be there. But whereas coming to here, realistic display is there, but relative parameters distance is not preserved here. Understood? Here it is missing a realistic display. But the space, the everything, the distance, everything will be preserved. But whereas coming to here, it preserves realistic display. Okay, this is in brief about parallel perspective projection. Let us describe in detail about parallel projection. What are the types? Everything we'll see now. So the first one is parallel projection. In case of parallel projection, let us consider you are projecting through x onto xy plane, then the z coordinate will be negligible. So we should not consider z coordinates are not considered. If you are considering a xy plane, then z coordinates are not considered. If you are projecting onto a yz plane, x coordinates are not considered. As an example, let us consider you are considering a xy plane. Okay, after that you need to consider, here we need to draw parallel lines so that the lines will be meeting the plane at one point. So let us consider an example. Okay, let us consider this is your plane. Now we need to draw parallel lines from this vertex from each vertex of that object to and that line should intersect at one point in your what is that called? U-plane. After getting drawing the parallel lines, we'll be getting the vertices, and these vertices are called projection vertices. Now we need to join these vertices by drawing the straight lines. So you'll get an object like this. Okay, this is how parallel projection will work. Remember, in parallel projection, you need to select one plane and the third coordinate will be not considered if you are selecting one plane. Right, as an example, I am considering xy plane, so z coordinate is not considered. And when projecting, for each and every vertex, you need to draw the parallel lines. And those parallel lines will be intersecting your view plane and we will be getting the projection vertices. Now, these projection vertices will be connected through the line segment. So, what are the different types? Now, depending upon these projection lines of direction, we are taking the projection lines. Depending upon the direction of these projection lines, the parallel projection is categorized into two. What are they? If the projection lines are perpendicular to your view plane, you can call it as a view plane or projection plane, to view plane, then it is called as orthographic projection. Otherwise, if the lines are not perpendicular to the view plane, otherwise it is called as oblique projection. That means, if the lines of projection, whatever you are considering, if they are perpendicular to your view plane, then such type of projection is called as orthographic projection. Otherwise, if they are not perpendicular, we need to take that type of projection as oblique projection. Now, the types of orthographic projections. Orthographic projection. Orthographic projections are again classified into three types, where the three types are, you can have a front projection, you can have a top projection, you can have a front projection, you can have a side projection. Because I said a 3D object can be viewed from the top, from the side or from the front. So like that you can have an orthographic projection where in all these three cases, front projection, top projection and side projection, remember the lines of projection should be perpendicular to your view plane. Let us consider one object like this. Okay, now if you want to have a side projection, let us consider this is your view plane. Okay, then from the side view, you should have a lines which should be perpendicular to your view plane. This is your side projection. Like this, you can have a projection from the left side also, or you can have a projection to the front and you can have a projection to the top also. Get it? Now, remember, here one more point is, if while projecting, if you are getting on a view plane which shows more than one face of your original object, then such type of projection is called as orthographic auxiliary projection. Orthographic auxiliary axonometric projection. That means orthographic axonometric projection. What is this projection is, if while projecting, your projecting lines will be perpendicular to your viewplane, while projecting, if you are getting more than one face, that means if you are getting, let us consider two faces of an object on your viewplane, then such type of projection is called as orthographic axonometric projection. This is about orthographic. Now coming to oblique projection. Remember, oblique projection is nothing but the lines of projection will not be perpendicular to your viewplane. Oblique. This oblique projection is categorized into two: Cavalier projection and cabinet projection. Generally, oblique projection is nothing but the lines of projection will not be perpendicular to your viewplane. Now, in cavalier projection, what happens is the lines of projection will make 45 degrees angle with your viewplane, whereas in cabinet projection, the lines of projection will make approximately 63.4 degrees of angle with your viewplane. In this, what happens is, if any line is perpendicular to your viewplane, then you will get that projected line, full length line. If any line is perpendicular to viewplane, then the line will get full length. But in case of cavalier projection, where the angle will be approximately 63.4 degrees, if it is perpendicular to viewplane, you will get half of its length. And this cavalier projection, if you are getting any object, these gives more realistic projections when compared to your cavalier projections. Here the angle will be 45 degrees, here the angle will be 63.4 degrees. This is completely about your parallel projections. In parallel projection, you need to draw the parallel lines from each vertex, and it is divided into two types: oblique and orthographic projection. In orthographic, the lines will be perpendicular. Here it may not be perpendicular. That's why we have considered 45 and 63.4 degrees. This is about parallel projection. Let's move on to our next concept, that is about perspective projection. Before that, let us derive the equations for our parallel projection. So let us derive the transformation matrix for your parallel projection. So as an example, let us consider we will be projecting onto our xy plane only. So I told you, like, whenever we are considering an xy plane, the z coordinate will be 0. We should not consider z coordinate. So let us see, in such case, what will be your transformation matrix. To derive that, let us consider the direction of projection is given with a vector called xp, yp, z. Let us call this is the vector which is given, which represents the direction of projection. And let us consider the point on your object is x1, y1, z1, and your projected point, a point on a viewplane. This is a point on your object. And let us consider this is called P1, and let us consider P2, which is X2, Y2, Z2, which is your point on viewplane. Right? Now let us derive the equations for that. We have a parametric equation. The parametric equation will be like this, where x1 plus xp into u. Let us consider u is of a constant. y2 equal to y1 plus xp into u. z2 equal to z1 plus xp into u. Remember, we are considering projection on a xy plane. That means this z2 will be 0. So this implies z1 plus xp, sorry, these are y, this is yp and this is zp, yp, zp. z1 plus zp into u is equal to 0, which implies you will get the value of u, which is equal equal to minus z1 by z3. Now if you substitute the z value in x1 and x2, you will get x2 equal to x1 plus xp into, you can say, minus xp into z1 by zp, and y2 is equal to y1 minus yp into z1 by zp. So by using these two equations, if you substitute, if you have a x1 y1 value, you have that x1 y1 value, you have z1 value z also, and you have your the projection vector value also. If you substitute those values, you will get the new coordinates in your on your xy plane. Thus, those new coordinate values are x2, y2. You can also represent that in your matrix form, and after substituting that matrix form, you can say like P dash equal to P into that whatever transformation you are applying into that transformation. This is about the transformation matrix about parallel projection. Let us move to our next type of projection, that is perspective projection. We already discussed it. Perspective projection is nothing but the corner points will be projected through the parallel lines. Those parallel lines will be converging at one center, that is called as projection center. So as an example, I have already told, if you are considering an object like this, if your view plane is like this, you should have a projection center, right? And this will be your object. Here, the relative proportions may not be maintained, but the realistic display will be there. Here you need to remember one more point is, depending upon the distance of your object also, the length of your projection object will be dependent. Like the objects which are at the, let me consider, the objects which are closer to your view plane will be looking very larger when compared to the object which are far away from your view plane. So let us consider an object which is of same length. Okay, now the object which is closer to the view plane, the length of this projected object will be more when compared to this one. So that is the case in case of perspective projection. And the types of perspective projections are, we have three types, that is 1-point projection, 2-point projection, and 3-point projection. This comes under 1-point projection. Where in case of, this comes under 1-point projection, where 2-point projection is, the object will be like this, where you can project in two directions. You have, let us consider this is a view plane, or you have two projection points in case of 2-point projection. And in case of 3-point projections, let us consider a triangle, where you can project in three directions, right? You can project in this direction, this is first projection point, you can project in this direction, this is second direction projection point, you can project in this direction also, this is third projection point. So these are three different types of projection points in your perspective projection. Let us derive the transformation matrix also for this perspective projection. So in this perspective projection, our inputs are, you should consider our projection point. Let us consider that projection point is xp, yp, zp. Projection point. Let us consider that projection point is xc, yc, zc, because we have already considered xp, yp, zp for our parallel projection. And your point on your object, let us consider it is x1, y1, z1. And your point on your projection plane, that is P2, let us consider that is X2, Y2, Z2. And remember, again we are considering XY plane to project. That means the Z coordinate should be equal to 0. Now the parametric equations are, you have, well, these are already derived, the parametric equations are X2 equal to xc plus x1 minus xc into u, y2 equal to yc plus y1 minus yc into u, z2 equal to zc plus z1 minus zc into u. But remember, as we are projecting onto xy plane, this value will be equal to 0. So this value will be equal to 0. This implies you will have a final value of u which is equal to minus zc by z1 plus minus zc, and you need to substitute this equation 1 in your x2 and y2. So finally you will get x2 equal to xc plus x1 minus xc into, you can say, minus zc by z1 minus zc, right? And y2 equal to yc minus zc into y1 minus yc by z1 minus zc. So using these two formulas, you can get a point on a projection plane, provided that you should have a projection point, center of projection point, you should have your a point on your object. This is about perspective projection. So in this projection, we have discussed about what actually a projection is, what are the different types of projections, and some classification of two types of projection, that is parallel projection and perspective projection. Thank you.